So spring is here, and I'm going to be showing you what I do to get ready on a spring day. So this is going to cover makeup, hair, and an outfit idea. So let's get started. So the first thing I do is I start my getting ready playlist, and I actually have a whole playlist on iTunes that has a little bit of Rachel Platten, Paper Kites, Mike Snow, Mariana's Trench, and that kind of just gets me ready for the day, and it's an hour long, so that gives me like an hour to get ready. So I'm just getting my breakfast together, and I like eating peanut butter with my banana, so that's why there's a little chunk of peanut butter there, and then I just made some tea, and Nugget came to join me for breakfast, and I just listen to music, eat my banana and peanut butter, and I browse Instagram, catch up on what's been going on Twitter, you know the drill. Then it's time to jump in the shower, and I like to start off by using my Living Proof Full Shampoo, which is great for adding volume, and it's sulfate-free, but still cleans your hair, and then I follow up with the Full Conditioner, which is awesome for detangling. And then to make my skin nice and silky and smooth, I use my Michael Todd Walnut and Grapefruit Polishing Scrub, and I just put this all over my body, and it's really nice. It's not too abrasive. It's very gentle, but it still gets all of like the dry skin off of you. And when you add water to it, it kind of works up into a little bit of a lather, and then you just rinse it off, and that's pretty much it. Then I like to come in with my Aveeno Daily Moisturizing Body Wash because it's moisturizing and it smells really good and it just gets me extra clean. And then it is time to brush my teeth, so I'm going to be using my Crest Complete toothpaste, brushing my teeth here. Moving on to washing my face, I like to use this cleansing water, and this is just a little travel size, but I take this on an exfoliating cotton pad, and I put it all over my face, and it just kind of gets any extra gunk that's sticking onto my skin. And then I've been using this serum from Caudalie, which I absolutely love. It's amazing at hydrating the skin, but it also helps to lighten up any kind of discoloration on your face, so I just put this all over, and then I pat it into my skin. And then it is time for my favorite daily moisturizer by Aveeno, and I just put this all over my face. For underneath my eyes, I love using the Michael Todd Intensive Organic Eye Cream, and this comes with a little pump, so it's great. You don't have to stick your finger into any kind of container, and it keeps things nice and sanitary. And now, instead of patting this completely into my under eye area, I've been using the Michael Todd Iosonic little infuser, and this helps your eye cream or serum completely absorb into your skin, and it has a little vibrator on the end that activates when you press it up against your skin. So you just start at the outer edges of your eyes and you work in circular motions, and it just gets all of the eye cream in, and it feels really good. So if you're interested in this, a link will be down below for you guys, as well as links for everything else. And when you're finished, all you have to do is wipe it off with a damp paper towel, replace the protective cover, and you're good to go. Now you guys know that I love the sweet and flirty scent from Victoria's Secret, and now I have the body butter, so I can put it all over my body, and this stuff smells really good. It's really hydrating, and I recently noticed that it has very subtle shimmer in it, so it's also really pretty. Once I'm finished moisturizing, then I just take my hair down from my towel and I use my Macadamia No Tangle Spray. And this stuff just helps to get the tangles out of my hair, and it also conditions it. Then I come in with my Aujon Damage Reverse Serum and I apply this to the ends of my hair. Once all of the product is worked in, then I come in with my wet brush, which is a brush that's designed specifically for use on wet hair, and it gets out all of the tangles and is really gentle. So now it's time for makeup, and I like to start off with the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Primer, and this stuff is awesome. If you have oily skin, this immediately makes your skin nice and matte. It's a great base for your foundation, and I love it. So I just smooth this all over my face, and then I follow up with my Urban Decay D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray, and I like using this before and after I apply my makeup, so this is the before spray. And once that's dry, then I come in with my Chanel Vita Lumiere Aqua Foundation. Give it a good shake since it does tend to separate, and then I just dot it all over my face. And then I use an angled foundation brush to blend everything in. Now I'm going to be using my Physician's Formula Conceal RX, and this stuff is awesome if you have discoloration, hyperpigmentation, blemishes, or anything like that on your face because it covers really, really well. For underneath my eyes, I like using the Bobbi Brown Corrector, and this stuff is great for covering up dark circles because it's a salmon-y color, so I just pat this underneath my eyes. And then for a little extra brightness, I use the Maybelline Dream Lumi Touch Highlighting Concealer, and I just pat this over the corrector. Coming in with the second spray of Urban Decay D-Slick, and moving on to my Chanel Mattifying Powder, and just dusting this all over my face. And then to fill in my brows, I'm going to be using this brow powder from Anastasia. And to make sure my brows keep their shape all day, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Great Lash Clear Mascara, and I'm just going to comb it through my brows. For eyeshadow primer, surprise, surprise, I'm using the NARS Eye Primer because it's my favorite and it helps keep my eyeshadows in place all day. Then, I'm going to be using my MAC Painterly Paint Pot, and I'm going to put this all over my lids, and this just creates a nice, even canvas for any eyeshadows that I put over the top. For eyeshadows, I'm going to be using Walk of Shame from the Naked Basics palette, and I'm going to put this all over my lids. And then I'm going to be using Naked 2 in the crease, and this is a really nice, natural looking crease color. It adds a little bit of definition, but it's not too dramatic. And then I'm going to take a little bit of Venus on my finger, and I'm going to pat it right in the center of my lids. And this just kind of brings more light to your eyes and makes them look brighter and just more awake. For eyeliner, I'm going to be using the Rimmel Scandalize Waterproof Kohl Kajal, and this is just a black color, and I'm going to use this to tightline the upper inner rims of my eyes. Now I'm going to be using Maybelline's Master Duo Liquid Liner, and I really love this stuff because you can control the thickness of the line just by turning the wand a little bit. So I'm just lining my upper lash line here, very carefully, since liquid liner sometimes can be an issue for me. If you watched my last video, then you know what I'm talking about. Then I'm going to take MAC Satin Taupe eyeshadow, and I'm going to mix it with this purple color from Maybelline's Lasting Lilac palette. And I'm just going to line my lower lash line with this color, and I really like it because you get that subtle hint of purple coming out through the satin taupe. Now it's time to curl my eyelashes. And for mascara, I'm going to be using Maybelline's The Rocket, and this is the waterproof formula because you guys know mascara smudges on me pretty easily, so waterproof is the way to go for me. And then I'm going to be using Clinique's Bottom Lash Mascara, which I have been loving recently. The small brush makes it great for getting those bottom lashes, and it doesn't smudge at all. Like, not a single smudge or flake, so it's amazing. For blush, I'm going to be using Rimmel's Pink Sorbet, and I'm going to be putting this just onto the apples of my cheeks. And then I'm going to come in with Milani's Luminoso blush, and I'm going to put this on the outer part of my cheeks. So it creates this really subtle gradient. For bronzer, I'm going to be using Jouer's Perfect Tan, which I've heard so many people rave about, and it's really the perfect tan color, so the name is very fitting for this product. On my lips, I'm going to be using Maybelline's Color Whisper in Coral Ambition, so I'm just going to put this all over my lips. And then I'm just gonna finish everything off with this Chroma lip gloss in Orange Blossom Honey. And this stuff is amazing, it tastes just like honey. So that is the finished look, and now moving on into my outfit. On top, I'm going to be wearing this floral shirt from Forever 21, distressed shorts from Abercrombie & Fitch, a braided belt that's also from Abercrombie & Fitch, shoes from Forever 21, and a bag that I found on sale at Madewell. Okay, so now for hair. I've let my hair completely air dry naturally, so I'm not using any heat. And now I'm going to part my hair down the center, and I'm going to take this elastic headband from Anthropologie, and I'm just going to put this over my head. And I'm going to pull out the two front sections of hair. So once you've separated your two sections, it's super easy from here. You're gonna take one of the sections and twist it, take it behind your head, and tuck it into the elastic part of the headband. Now I'm gonna turn around and show you guys what it looks like from the back. So I'm twisting the other section, pulling it behind my head, and then tucking it into the elastic. Now you're going to want to separate the remainder of your hair into 3 or 4 sections depending on the thickness, and you're going to keep twisting, then wrapping and tucking your hair into the elastic. This hairstyle is super quick and easy to do, and once you kind of get the hang of it, you really don't even need a mirror to do it, so that's pretty awesome. And I will say throughout the day, you may have to do some maintenance tucks because some of the pieces can fall out a little bit, but that's pretty much it. It's really easy to fix and maintain, and this is what it looks like when you're finished with everything. For fragrance, I'm going to be using the new Daisy Oh So Fresh Sunshine scent, and if you love the original like I do, you will love this one. So this is how everything looks all together, and I'm just gonna go into some close-ups so you guys can kind of get a better look at everything. So here we go! I also have on this rose mid-finger ring, which I love, and then this infinity ring. And last but not least, on my nails, I'm wearing Essie's First Timer. So that pretty much completes the entire look, and I hope you guys are having an amazing day. I hope you have an awesome spring, and I'll see you guys later. Bye!